Okay, so let's start by familiarising ourselves with the parts you buy in the kit. Obviously you've got your nutrient tray, which is the bottom tank. Note that inside here you have two cutouts, one, two. This is to note the min and max levels for your nutrient. Obviously any lower than that, the pump won't be able to push it through. Any higher than this, and the nutrient won't be able to flow off of the top tray, therefore it won't be doing its job by recirculating. Okay, so that's the tank. On top of that goes the top tray, like so. And then everything else that you see in front of us is from the box, meaning that consists of a pump. You have your delivery tube, an air line for the pump, a spreader mat, and a pH test kit for your nutrients, and a Corex lid with your instructions. Okay, the pump assembly is pretty straightforward. It's already got its suction cups on the bottom, so there's no need to worry about those. You literally just connect your air line to the side of the pump like so, and then your delivery tube gets attached on top of the pump. Like so. That's pretty much the size of it. What happens is then you just drop it in. There's a little hole in the top of the tank there that you drop your delivery tube through, and then you can position the whole thing onto the floor of the tank like so, so it's nice and secure. The line goes through there to be plugged in. With the air line, put it over this side so that it's just hanging loose for the air to come out. On another note with the air line, it's good to unscrew this fully to allow a full amount of air to be implemented into your pump so that it's much better for your system. And that's the system set up. Okay, now for the layout of the kit, basically, as I said, you get your spreader mat here, but for the purposes of this illustration, I've already cut a couple of pieces out to show you, and you literally lay them into the bottom of the top tray, like so. This is to give the roots something to adhere to, and also allow even distribution of your nutrients, okay, which comes out of this pump. So basically, you can see I've laid them into there like so, and again, make sure it's fully covered the bottom tray, okay? Now, moving on to the blocks and stuff, it really depends on what medium you want to use, but for this I'm just explaining it with the rock wall. As you can imagine, that's a starter cube. They come in inch or half inch sizes, which you put your seed or your cutting into to root through. Once the roots have come through the bottom, you pre-soak a larger block. Again, you do different sizes depending on what you're using them for. And then that's then placed into there like so. And once they've rooted out of the bottom of there, they're really ready to go into the spreader mat. So you could position them just in theory like so. So on this GT205 kit, that's a four plant system spread out nice and evenly so they won't conflict each other when they grow up a little bit bigger. And that's really the bottom line. And then the last thing to show you is the Corex lid. Again, depending on how you position those is how you would cut the top of this lid. If you can imagine, it would sit on like that. So you'd literally cut holes so that the rock wall blocks are pointing out at the top and it would lay firmly on there, again, to light proof your nutrients. And that's about the size of it. Thanks for listening.